Hello everyone, welcome to Lukman IAS. Today we are going to have the Hindu analysis of 27th January 2021. So let us see which are the important articles in today's the Hindu newspaper. Yes, so these are the articles. Let us take overview of these articles. These articles for mains examination, like first article on page number 6, editorial page. It is talking about need of pursuing India's national interest as well as when we talk about the non-permanent membership of India that has started this year from 1st January 2021 for 2-year term, and this is the good opportunity that India should, let's say, consider mark its important place in the world order that has been disarrayed because of, let's say, the trade wars or the conflict that is going on between USA and China, and China's, let's say, increasing assertion at the world order, or we can say international platforms. So that's why it becomes important for India to, let's say, ensure its national interest at this United Nations Security Council. Okay, at the same time, second article, we are not all in the same boat. Basically, here the writer is head of Oxfam, non-profit organization, and recently we have seen, yesterday itself, we have seen the highlights of the Oxfam report this year released by Oxfam, and the article is discussing how economic inequality has deepened in our society during this pandemic period. Okay, last 1 year. So, very good arguments, analysis given here from social justice, society, and let's say inclusive growth and development. Ye jo topics hote hai, essay ke liye bhi important hai, right? So, we'll discuss that topic from that perspective. Many vulnerabilities, polity and governance. Here in editorial, page number 6, the article is discussing about the concerns associated with use of remote voting system, or the pilot project that is being, let's say, validated by the Election Commission, and therefore it is talking about the use of blockchain technology in remote voting in that project and the concerns associated with that. Okay, so here we can talk about the role of technology in the governance process or free and fair elections. So, jaise pehle bhi EVM ke saath mein kuch issues hue the regarding the, let's say, tampering of EVM machines. तो कैसे इलेक्शन कमीशन ने उसका जो सिक्योरिटी है वो लोगों तक पहुंचाया है, द अवेयरनेस जो है उसके बारे में. सो इन दिस मैनर वील डिस्कस दिस आर्टिकल ऑल्सो, राइट? एट द सेम टाइम फ्रॉम प्रिलिम्स पर्सपेक्टिव, लाइक 50 ईयर्स ऑफ लेट्स से बांग्लादेश लिबरेशन वॉर, ठीक है, तो उसके बारे में यहाँ पे जो उनका जो एक कॉन्टिजेंट था उसमें रिपब्लिक परेड में उन्होंने पार्टिसिपेट किया है. सम इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्ट्स आर गिवन हियर. So, post-independence history, that is also part of your mains examination, GS1 paper, and for prelims also it is important. At the same time, on economy page here, or the world page, on page number 14, here, Cain threatens the Indian asset seizures abroad in tax case. So, it is talking about the the tax arbitration case that has been, let's say, given in a favor of केन एनर्जी, ठीक है, एक कंपनी है, मल्टीनेशनल कंपनी है, एंड दिस कंपनी हैज लेट्स से सूड इंडिया इन दैट रिट्रोस्पेक्टिव टैक्स केस, ठीक है, जो टैक्स उन पे लगाए गए थे. तो यहाँ पे हम कुछ प्रीलिम्स रिलेटेड फैक्ट्स देखेंगे, व्हाट इज न्यूयॉर्क कन्वेंशन, व्हाट इज परमानेंट कोर्ट ऑफ आर्बिट्रेशन, एंड सम लेट्स से बेसिक्स अबाउट इट फॉर प्रीलिम्स एग्जामिनेशन, ठीक है, जो इंटरनेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस होते हैं उसके लिए हमें इंपॉर्टेंट है. सो इन दिस मैनर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दिस आर्टिकल्स. सो फर्स्ट आर्टिकल ऑन पेज नंबर 6, परस्यूइंग नेशनल इंटरेस्ट एट यूएन हाई टेबल. ओके, सो दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर GS2 पेपर, मेन्स एग्जामिनेशन, इंटरनेशनल रिलेशन का जो सेक्शन है उसके लिए जरूर आपको 2021 मेन्स में ये क्वेश्चन आ सकता है. सो इंडिया हैज बीन इलेक्टेड फॉर नॉन परमानेंट मेंबरशिप ऑफ 2-year टर्म स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 2021, 1st January 2021. तो उसके बाद 2 साल के लिए अभी हम नॉन परमानेंट मेंबर. सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द बेसिक्स, यूनाइटेड नेशंस हैज द United Nations Security Council, which is having the primary objective. Now, primary objective of this UNSC is that to ensure peace and stability in the world. ठीक है, तो पीस स्टेबिलिटी एंड सिक्योरिटी इन द वर्ल्ड, दिस इज द प्राइमरी ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस यूएनएससी. दिस यूएनएससी इज हैविंग 15 मेंबर्स. ओके, एंड अमंग दिस 15 मेंबर्स देर आर 5 परमानेंट मेंबर्स एंड 10 नॉन परमानेंट मेंबर्स. ओके, सो इंडिया हैज बीन इलेक्टेड फॉर दिस एंड इंडिया कंटेंट्स फॉर दिस. India wants to be included in the wants permanent seat in this UNSC because there are more powers, let's say, given to this permanent five. Which are these permanent five? USA, UK, Russia, France and China. ठीक है, तो ये पांच जो है इसको permanent five बोलते हैं UNSC के member. Fine, this was about basics. Now, what is given here in the article? It discusses important aspects when we talk about, let's say, India's membership at UNSC. Now, what India can do when during this 2-year term? Why it is important? First, you can talk about the significance. Why it is important? We can say that at present, the world is, facing many problems, including pandemic. Okay, so when we talk about the political, or PSIR perspective, political science and international relations perspective, here we can talk about the world is moving towards another Cold War era. Okay, there are two blocks being created, one that is led by USA, another now that is being led by the China. ठीक है, तो ये जो है, दिस इज एट प्रेजेंट द सिनेरियो. एट द सेम टाइम द होल वर्ल्ड इज फेसिंग द COVID-19 पैंडेमिक, विच इज अगेन हैविंग द इम्पैक्ट ऑन होल वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमी एज वेल एज लेट्स से जियो स्ट्रेटेजिक एस्पेक्ट्स ऑल्सो. ओके, सो इन दिस मैनर व्हेन इंडिया इज इलेक्टेड टू दिस यूएनएससी नॉन परमानेंट मेंबरशिप, इंडिया कैन प्ले द असर्टिव रोल टू एंश्योर इट्स नेशनल इंटरेस्ट एंड increase or expand its role at the international level. So this is the significance we can talk about. At the same time, what India can do here is India can pressurize China at UNSC. Okay, important to contain China. So basically here we can understand the China is increasing its assertiveness in Asia region, especially the Southeast Asia. When we talk about the disputes in South China Sea, we can also talk about the LAC event, that LAC standoff between India and China. Okay, so this is what is happening, and therefore India can rally the whole world against such kind of policies of China. Next, we can say that the terrorism. So, India has been always, the terrorism has been always the focal point when India is talking at the United Nations. Okay, so again, the focal area will be terrorism. At the same time, when India has any policy making towards containing terrorism in the world, there should be some kind of certainty. Okay, when we talk about the terrorism related or counter terrorism policy making at UNSC. Okay, so realism and continuity is very important when we talk about the anti terrorism policy at UNSC. Then we can also talk about the other factors or issues, like we can also talk about the non proliferation, disarmament and other such issues like peaceful use of global commons, sustainable use of global commons like space, high seas and all. So here the like-minded countries can be rallied by the India, or India can lead this country so as to ensure, or let's say deliberate on these issues. So again, this is an important area where the India can use this opportunity at UNSC. Okay, such points of such important points can be written here when we talk about India's, or the significance or importance of India being elected as non-permanent member in UNSC. ठीक है, तो यही आर्टिकल में वो डिस्कस किया गया है. सो यू कैन टेक इनपुट अकॉर्डिंगली फ्रॉम दिस आर्टिकल. ओके, यस. सो मूविंग ऑन, नेक्स्ट आर्टिकल, वी आर नॉट ऑल इन द सेम बोट. सो बेसिकली हियर द राइटर इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द काइंड ऑफ इनइक्वालिटी दैट वी आर फेसिंग एट प्रेजेंट, एंड इट इज एग्रेवेटेड बाय द COVID-19 pandemic. Now, the direct question that has been asked this year mains examination, first let us look at this question. COVID-19 pandemic accelerated class inequalities and poverty in India. Comment. Class inequalities and poverty in India. Now, class inequality focuses on economic inequality, rich, poor, and the poverty. So basically here you can directly take input from this article or such kind of articles, or use some data and facts from such reports. Okay, so this is important. At the same time, there can be essay from this inclusive growth and development, economic inequality, economic disparities. Okay, at the same time you have to understand that when we talk about such kind of, let's say, inequality, you have to understand the basic philosophy of our constitution. Okay, and our Indian constitution in preamble and DPSPs, it talks about socio-economic justice. Socio-economic justice and equality. And when we talk about socio-economic justice and equality, there are provisions in DPSPs wherein state needs to, let's say, bring such policies, schemes, or let's say legal provisions for ensuring economic equality. Okay, so ensuring economic equality, social equality. And we can see here the kind of impact the pandemic has in increasing such inequality that has been already present in our society. This is very disturbing picture. Okay, so you need to take input such as, for example, some factual or data from this report. For example, we can also talk about, like, whatever the impact we have seen here is largely on poor women, or we can say a kind of racial discrimination, Divyang people. Okay, and we can also talk about children and aged people. So basically those who are the marginal sections of society are these are more let's say impacted or affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. Okay, so what it is providing here, for example, here, like, increase in the wealth of top 11 billionaires during the pandemic can easily sustain MG Narega scheme or health ministry for next 10 years. So such kind of increase, the article is also providing some, let's say, facts about the kind of wealth that has been generated by Ambani, is the richest person in India or Asia, also in Asia. At the same time, there is unemployment, and more people are falling into the poverty because of pandemic. On one side, the rich are becoming richer and poor are becoming poorer. This is what this report is highlighting here. At the same time, the increase in burden of the work of the women, or we can say that the household work, non-paid work, unpaid work that is done by the women, that has been increased. We can understand that the people are working from home. Somehow the women are also working from home. At the same time, many women are, or we can say, they lost their jobs because some occupations cannot be worked from home. right? So such kind of, let's say, things are happening because of pandemic. At the same time, now we are having, let's say, the path to recovery, wherein male are, let's say, having more possibility to get the jobs as compared to women in our country. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे आर्टिकल में काफ़ी अच्छा वे फॉरवर्ड भी दिया हुआ है, एंड इन दैट वे फॉरवर्ड वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट द फोकस ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट इन इन्वेस्टमेंट, व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द पब्लिक इन्वेस्टमेंट, दैट इन्वेस्टमेंट शुड गो टू द सोशल सेक्टर्स. सोशल सेक्टर में सबसे ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट क्या आता है? फर्स्ट इज हेल्थ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, सेकेंड इज एजुकेशनल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, एंड थर्ड वी कैन टॉक अबाउट द स्किल डेवलपमेंट. Okay, at the along with these three, there should be focus on, or let's say, public expenditure on infrastructure development. Okay, so this should be the first part here. Invest in free universal healthcare, education and other public services. Okay, now the second important aspect here is that more and more people should be given the social security or income security. When the people have income security, it brings a kind of, or let's say, sense of security among the people to take some risk or do the jobs, and this reduces the kind of fear due to such kind of pandemic. ठीक है, तो हम यहाँ पे बोल सकते हैं guaranteed income security is essential. Here you can also talk about universal basic income. The proposal of universal basic income needs to be more analyzed, and from Indian context we can adopt such kind of proposal, universal basic income. At the same time, as we have seen here in DPSPs, one of the objective is redistribution of wealth, and for that purpose we have adopted many such policies, and one of them is progressive taxation. Okay, and therefore wealthier people should be taxed more, and that too in such kind of situation, or let's pandemic situation, there should be such kind of wealth tax should be reintroduced. Already there was wealth tax, but that was abolished earlier during the economic reforms. However, that should be, let's say, reintroduced, as we know that wealthier people have escaped the impact of COVID-19, while the poor people are bearing the brunt of this pandemic. Okay, and therefore wealthier people should be taxed more. We can understand that being the the socialist nature of Indian state or Indian society, this aim is included, or this word is included in our preamble through 42nd Amendment Act. तो हमें ये चीज पता होनी चाहिए कि what is the aim of the Indian state or the Indian constitution in preamble, socialist government or socialist state. ओके, तो हम रीडिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ वेल्थ की बात करेंगे, एंड लास्टली वी शुड ऑल्सो इन्वेस्ट इन ग्रीन इकोनॉमी. सो व्हाट इट इज टॉकिंग अबाउट ग्रीन इकोनॉमी, इट इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट, सस्टेनेबल इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ. दैट मीन्स एनवायरमेंट प्रोटेक्शन शुड बी साइमल्टेनियस फोकस व्हेन वी अडॉप्ट एनी इकोनॉमिक रिकवरी पाथ इन आफ्टर दिस पैंडमिक और पोस्ट पैंडमिक पीरियड. ओके, सो बेसिकली इट इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द फोकस ऑन ग्रीन इकोनॉमी should be simultaneous focus when we talk about the inclusive growth and development. ठीक है, तो ये आर्टिकल में यहाँ पे बताया गया है कि social justice or the impact of pandemic on the society, especially when we talk about the economic inequality, economic disparity, income disparity we have. So ये GS1 में इस तरीके से question पूछा था, हम इस आर्टिकल से direct input ले सकते हैं. Fine. In addition, you need to know about the basic philosophy of Indian Constitution. You can mention that in this answer. Okay. Next, many vulnerabilities. So here the context of the article, recently Election Commission of India has come up with some proposals of electoral reforms, and one of the project, remote voting project, is being validated by the Election Commission of India. This technology is being developed by IIT Madras, Indian Institute of Technology Madras, and it uses blockchain technology. Now this is basic information for prelims examination. Now how blockchain technology works, that has been already asked in prelims examination for two times, and let's say when we talk about the voting system, so blockchain method implements the online public bulletin board that allows for linear ordering of data, to which the user can only further append data. Basically, you need to know that blockchain technology has already been used in let's say cryptocurrencies. Okay, तो cryptocurrencies जो होते हैं तो उनमें use किया गया है, जैसे bitcoin है cryptocurrencies. So basically here there is no third party who can monitor such kind of transactions that are happening. However, for voting purpose we need to have the third party, like we need to have the monitoring by, or let's say sanctioning of these transactions by election commission itself. So yahan pe kuch concern aata hai. Second concern here it is talking about, surely this kind of technology will be connected with the internet, and such kind of let's say softwares which are connected to networks and let's say devices, they are always vulnerable for tampering. This we can understand that the concerns associated with EVM, electronic voting machine, yes, last few years this was in news for much of the time, because many let's say section of the, or we can say experts, political experts criticize this EVM. There were also malfunctioning of EVM, such kind of events happened, and therefore the public trust in free and fair election was somehow compromised, and therefore election commission had come up with the proposal of VVPAT, okay, voter variable we can say paper audit trail. ठीक है, तो voter variable paper audit trail, this is attached to this EVM machine. Basically EVM machine is standalone machine, it is not connected to any let's say network or other device, and therefore it is very, let's say there is least possibility of tampering, because security measures are inbuilt in that. Whenever a device is connected to network or internet, somehow there is possibility of tampering with that system. ठीक है, तो ये एक concern है यहाँ पे remote voting का. If we talk about the kind of voting that has been done in US election, US presidential election, mail-in ballot system. Now this mail-in ballot system is entirely paper-based. We can understand that there is no let's say network connections that is attached with the any system of voting here, and therefore that was let's say trustworthy system. But this remote voting project or remote voting system will somehow require more and more security measures, and therefore election commission needs to put in place such security measures before using that for or using in actual elections. At the same time it needs to let's say validate that system or that project, that technology to the people, so that people get trust on that system. And somehow that is very important in democratic country, because free and fair election is the most important tenet of any democracy. Fine. So this is what the article is discussing. Lastly, the question: analyze the concerns associated with use of technology such as blockchain technology in conducting free and fair elections in India. So you can discuss the concerns. Fine. ठीक है, तो GS2 पेपर में आपको पता होना चाहिए इलेक्टोरल रिफॉर्म्स, यूज ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी इन गवर्नेंस. नेक्स्ट, यस, इन द फुटस्टेप्स ऑफ लीजेंडरी मुक्ति जोधास. सो हियर मुक्ति जोधास ऑफ मुक्ति वाहिनी और मुक्ति बहिनी जिसको बोलते हैं हम, दे फॉट वैलियंटली इन बांग्लादेश लिबरेशन वॉर. ओके, and 50 years of this liberation war is being celebrated, and India, Bangladesh, both countries are celebrating this with various events, and one of the events, this Republic Day parade, what we can say, the contingent of Bangladesh marched on Rajpath at this Republic Day parade. Okay, so what is important for our examination, for prelims examination, two important points: operation, what you can say, jackpot, operation jackpot of Bangladesh Navy during this liberation war, and Bangladesh Air Force, this was operation Kilo Flight. ठीक है, तो ये आपको पता होना चाहिए factual information में, right? Along with that you can you need to know about what kind of question that has been already asked in your GS1 paper 2013. Critically examine the compulsions which prompted India to play decisive roles in emergence of Bangladesh. 2013 mein ye question pucha gaya tha. Right. So for that purpose, you need to know the history, how Pakistan started the Operation Searchlight in 1971 against, let's say, those who were revolting against the government in East Pakistan during that period, and somehow that resulted into civil war, or the people started migrating into Indian borders or Indian territory because of that. That led to pressure on India to take certain actions. At the same time, Pakistan also started bombarding Indian air bases at that time, and therefore the war was declared between India and Pakistan. And India or Indian army trained Mukti Vahinis. These were armed, let's say, rebellions to fight against the, let's say, Pakistani army. Guerrilla tactics were used. At the same time, after India won the war, somehow the army of the Pakistan surrendered, and after that Shimla Agreement was passed. Shimla Agreement 1972. Now in this agreement, Pakistan agreed the establishment of or liberation of Bangladesh, or establishment of Bangladesh as a separate country. Okay. At the same time, the prisoners of wars were returned by both countries with each other. ठीक है, तो ये Shimla Agreement जो है after Bangladesh Liberation War 1971. ठीक है. So these are important events that happened during that time. The compulsions आपको ये चीज पता होनी चाहिए. The people started migrating to India. Somehow that pressurized India to take certain actions. At the same time, the Pakistan was violating the ceasefire on both borders. ठीक है, तो वो दोनों साइड से प्रेशर था, तो कहीं ना कहीं हमें इमिजिएटली एक्शन लेना था. एट द सेम टाइम पाकिस्तान वॉज गेटिंग सम सपोर्ट फ्रॉम USA. US मरीन्स वेर नियरिंग इन द बे ऑफ बंगाल. सो ये एक सारे कंपल्शंस थे, एंड डिसिजिव रोल वॉज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी टेकन एट दैट टाइम. ठीक है, सो यू कैन write or attempt such question after understanding these sequence of events. Okay, for prelims as well as mains examination, you can take input. At the same time, you have to understand, if we look at the trend, after 2013, there was no question asked from this part of syllabus. So maybe next year you can expect such kind of question from this syllabus. Post independence. ठीक है, तो एक ही साल में उन्होंने 3-4 क्वेश्चन पूछ लिए थे 2013 में. उसके बाद उन्होंने उस पार्ट ऑफ सिलेबस से कभी क्वेश्चन नहीं पूछा है अभी तक. ओके, सो यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दैट पार्ट. नेक्स्ट, यस, केन एनर्जी, ये जो कंपनी है यूके बेस्ड कंपनी है. सो इट थ्रेटन इंडियाज एसेट सीजर्स अब्रॉड इन टैक्स केस. So context that UK based Ken Energy has threatened that it may be forced to begin attaching Indian assets, including bank accounts in different world capitals, unless the government resolves the issue. So here issue it is talking about that the 3-member tribunal at Permanent Court of Arbitration at The Hague that had delivered its verdict in December 2020 had held unanimously in favor of this company Ken against the Indian government. ठीक है, so Indian government has put the retrospective taxes on this company, and this company went to the permanent court of arbitration, and these two parties fought the case in that tribunal, and the final verdict was in favor of the company. Okay, and therefore the company want the compensation now from the Indian government. Right, so this is the news here. But for prelims examination, 2 important points: Permanent Court of Arbitration and New York Convention is important. So New York Convention, it is also called as the Convention on Recognition and Enforcement of Foreign Arbitral Awards. India is party to this convention. It came into force in 1959, and it is for whatever the awards that has been given by the international tribunals, that they should be enforced. So ye convention ka part hai. The parties are obliged to let's say enforce the final verdict of or the award of this tribunals, arbitral awards. Right. At the same time, the Permanent Court of Arbitration, it was established in 1899 as international or intergovernmental body, which is not, let's say, having any kind of, let's say, judicial aspect. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे एक traditional sense में एक court नहीं है, rather it is arbitral tribunal to resolve the disputes. Okay, so arbitration is important, let's say, a concept that is gaining more and more traction in recent times, because the foreign investment by these multinational companies depends on somehow the arbitration process. ठीक है, because there will be somehow conflict between these companies and the government policies of the host country, and therefore the quick arbitration of these issues to resolve these issues is very important. And therefore, let's say the role of Permanent Court of Arbitration is also important. Okay. Now, some important points here. It is located in Peace Palace at The Hague, Netherlands, capital of Netherlands. ठीक है, तो ये Peace Palace जो है, यहाँ पे दूसरे भी जो हम बोल सकते हैं institutions है, for example, ICJ, International Court of Justice. At the same time, it houses Hague Academy of International Law and Peace Palace Library. तो ये चार चीजें हैं Peace Palace में. ठीक है, so यहाँ पे International Criminal Court जो है, ठीक है, तो वो Criminal Court का यहाँ पे नहीं है Peace Palace में, though it is located in Hague. Okay, ICJ and Permanent Court of Arbitration, they are located in Peace Palace. This is important. At the same time, it is not United Nations agency, though it is, let's say, official observer of United Nations. ठीक है, तो it is not agency, जैसे कि ICJ is the specialized agency of United Nations. ठीक है, ICJ, International Court of Justice. It is having some kind of, let's say, judicial nature, but this Permanent Court of Arbitration is for arbitration purpose. ठीक है, so this important aspect. Member parties, 122 states. At the same time, it is not only, let's say, resolving the disputes between countries, rather it is also resolving the disputes between countries and companies, or let's say non-state actors. At the same time, among the companies, or let's say non-governmental organizations. Okay, so not only the governments or state, but others also. ठीक है, so this is basic information for prelims, and on the basis of that information you can attempt this prelims question, and you can answer in the comment box of this video so that we can have the interaction, two way interaction and communication for that purpose. You can attempt this question from the given information. Some important captions and quotations that are given here in these articles from today's The Hindu newspaper. Yes, so here in first part, this New Delhi's entry into UNSC coincides with emergence of new world order, one marked by systematic uncertainty, little care for global commons, absence of global leadership, the steady division of the world into rival blocs, and the age marked by unabashed pursuit of narrow national interest. Very good statement, directly can be used when we talk about IR related question or related essay topic also. Here, the impact of COVID-19, very good statement by UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres. So, he had said that COVID-19 has been likened to X-ray, revealing fractures in fragile skeleton of the societies we have built. Very good statement that can be directly used in your essay paper. When we talk about the question that we are discussing here, the impact of COVID-19, आप इसको introduction या conclusion में directly use कर सकते हो. छोटा सा statement, यहाँ तक ही use करो, right? So here we can say that this can be used in COVID-19 pandemic impact on society. तो इससे related कोई भी question हो और essay हो, तो आप use करो.
Fine.
So these were important articles from today's The Hindu newspaper. For further information on editorial discussion classes or ED classes, wherein in-depth analysis of mains related issues and articles from various perspectives and a perspective building is done on those issues by Ansari sir and team, you can contact Lukman IAS. Thank you.